difficulties in our life, we know that God is always there for us, and we know that God will never leave us nor forsake us, because that was His promise. And also we are blessed also by first special number. Ganda. So, iniwan kami ni Cedric eh. Trio kami. Inuubo daw siya. Okay, let's pray for Brother Cedric na makarecover sa kanyang ubo. Okay. So, sa hapong ito, I was blessed by the testimony. Challenge si Sister Luwang. We are blessed by the testimony of Sister Luwang. Nakahiya na tuloy mag-Tagalog. English tayo. Iba talaga when you talk to a person, yung mga natural speaker. Kaya ako na dyan sanay. Ako, wala ganito. Si Deo kasi lagi kausap ko. Sublime. Kasi naman ba? Okay, let's all stand up. Let's open our Bible in the book of Luke. Luke chapter 24. Nanginginig yung tuhod ko. Luke 24, verse 13 to 35. Luke 24, verses 13 until 35. Let's read this responsibly. Verse 13. And behold, two of them went that same day to a village called Emmaus, which was from Jerusalem about 80 furlongs. And it came to pass that while they communed together and reasoned, Jesus himself drew near and went with them.
But their eyes were holden, that they should not know him.
And he said unto them, What manner of communications are this that ye have one to another, as ye walk and are said? And he said unto them, What things? And they said unto him concerning Jesus of Nazareth, which was a prophet mighty in deed and word before God and all the people.
And how chief priests and our rulers delivered him to be condemned to death, and have crucified him.
But we trusted that it had been he which should have redeemed Israel. And besides all this, today is the third day since these things were done.
Yea, and certain women also of our company made us astonished, which were early at the sepulchre.
And when they found not his body, they came, saying that they had also seen a vision of angels, which said that he was alive. Then he said unto them, O fools, and slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken.
What that Christ to have suffered these things, and to enter into his glory?
And beginning at Moses and all the prophets, he expounded unto them in all the scripture the things concerning himself. But they constrained him, saying, Abide with us, for it is toward evening, and the day is far spent. And he went in to tarry with them.
And it came to pass that he sat and ate with them. He took bread and blessed it, and brake, and gave it to them.
And their eyes were opened, and they knew him, and he vanished out of their sight.
Not our heart burned within us while he talked with us by the way, and
And they rose up the same hour and returned to Jerusalem and found the 11 gathered together and them that were with them. Altogether, and they told what things were done in the way, and how he was known of them in breaking of bread. Let's come to the Lord in prayer. Our Father in heaven, Lord, thank you for this time. Thank you so much, Lord, for this opportunity that we can study your word. I pray, Lord, that you will give us wisdom as we study your word, illumine our hearts and our minds. I pray, Lord, that the Holy Spirit will speak to each every one of us and give words to my mouth, Almighty God, because I cannot do it without you. I'm trusting on your power, Almighty God, and use me as a channel of blessing to your people. And thank you so much, Lord, for your goodness and faithfulness to our life, that whatever we are experiencing at this time, you are always there for us. You will never leave us nor forsake us. We praise you, Almighty God, and we're asking for forgiveness of our sins, all these things. I ask and pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Okay, you all may be seated. So this story about after the Lord Jesus Christ was crucified on Calvary and he was risen, it was we can find this story in the book of Luke, in the Gospel of Luke. You cannot see that in other Gospels. Only in the book of Luke, where these two travelers, we know that these two are also a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ. And we know when the Lord Jesus Christ was ministering to during his time, he has many disciples, not only the 12 disciples. That's why we can read here, when they hear the story of the Lord Jesus Christ, they knew that it was the Lord Jesus. They go back and talk to the 11. It pertains to the 12, 11 disciples. Judas was not there anymore. That's what this story is all about. When they traveled from Jerusalem, going to a place called Emmaus, and according to when I studied that, it was a 7 kilometer or 7 miles walk from Jerusalem and to that place. So imagine if you're going to walk with that that far. I think it will take you many hours to travel. Now during their traveling, they were so disappointed. They were sad. Their hope was gone. But the Lord Jesus Christ appeared to them when they traveling during their journey. The Lord Jesus Christ meet them, rebuke them, and then tell a story about him. Now the title of our message today is I titled it The Journey. Hindi yung kay Leia Salonga, may journey yung kante. The Journey. Now here, the travel from Jerusalem going to Emmaus, because we know that the Lord Jesus Christ was crucified and he died. And that's what they said here. 3 days he was dead. Tatlong araw na siyang patay, sabi ng dalawang ito. It was mentioned here the name of the other person. Name is Cleopas, but the other one, it's unnamed a person. We don't know if it's his wife or maybe his son or his another relatives, because they will go back to their place. Because they think they have no any reason to stay at Jerusalem. Their leader was gone, their master was gone, they're dead, and that's why they go back to that place. Now, here, while they are traveling, going back to Emmaus, number one here we can see here in verse 13 to 17, and behold, two men went that same day to a village called Emmaus, which was from Jerusalem about threescore furlongs, and they talked together all these things which had happened. They tried to recall what happened to the Lord Jesus Christ, what happened to them, why it happens to their group. And they were, number one, they traveled the journey of disappointment. It was a journey of disappointment. We know sometimes we grow disappointed with God. We can see here why they are traveling from Jerusalem going to Emmaus. Letter 8, they were depressed. They were depressed because their leader was crucified and died. It was the Lord Jesus Christ. Their hope was gone. You know, during those times when the Lord Jesus Christ was crucified, you know, the disciples were scattered. They ran away. Only John the Baptist stayed, and Mary on that place where Jesus Christ was crucified, because they were afraid of their life. And then they were sad. Perhaps they are even angry with God for dashing their hopes, for not answering their prayers. Sometimes it seems God let us down in our life. You know, God doesn't come through for us the way we expect. We know that God is always there, but sometimes we are expecting something from God that He will do this for us because we want that for our life. But God has a better plan for us, because sometimes when we pray, sometimes when we ask God, it is sometimes according to our flesh. That's why when we ask something for God, we need to align it according to His will and according to the Word of God. Now, the reason why they were this depressed, because their leader was crucified. You know, if you are a follower of somebody and that person died, you will feel depressed too. Like yung kay si Almeida, yung Jesus, ano ba yun? Miracle Crusade, Jesus Miracle Crusade. Diba yung namatay si Almeida, talagang halos magkawatak-watak sila, pero nabuo, tinuloy ng asawa. Natuloy ng asawa. Ganun po, namatay kasi ang kanilang leader, that's why they were depressed. And then, when they are traveling, going back to Emmaus, they were so sad. They were, they talk about what happened. And then, it seems they said, well, parang wala nang mangyayari sa atin. Anong gagawin natin? Wala na ang Panginoon. May pinangako siya na ililigtas niya ang Israel, ililig-deliver niya tayo. Mamaya titingnan niya natin mamaya. Pero what happened was they didn't expect that. Although God is telling, the Lord Jesus Christ is telling that to them. Maybe they forgot. I can see it here. And then, not only they were depressed as they journeyed of disappointment, they were also deaf. They don't want to share anymore their experience about the Lord Jesus Christ. They don't want to go to any place to share what the Lord Jesus Christ is teaching them about His goodness, about the salvation, about the gospel. You know, same with us. When we are disappointed, we become deaf about God's goodness and salvation. That's the problem sometimes in our life. If we are disappointed, we don't want to work for the Lord. You know, when we are disappointed, I think that's the time we need to come closer to God. That's the time we need God more in our life. Because like, you know, remember David. When David was distressed, when David was disappointed, what did he do? He didn't wait for somebody to encourage him. He didn't wait for somebody to tap his back, or to say something and to say an encouraging word for him, but he encouraged himself for the Lord. We need to encourage ourselves for the Lord. If we are disappointed and we experience all these circumstances, problems in our life, we don't need to just stay doing nothing, like what we are experiencing today. Like this past few months that we don't have jobs, and actually we are thinking, how can we survive? But God is still, God really, like what Pastor said a while ago, God is always there for us. He's good. He will always supply. He will always provide. Now that's why we don't need to be disappointed. But that it will happen to us. When we are disappointed, we don't want to work for the Lord. We don't want to tell the gospel. We don't want to go to the outreach or ministry. I know we experience that in our life, especially when we are disappointed of something that we are asking for the Lord, and then it didn't happen. So maybe we are thinking, oh, I don't want to do it anymore. I don't want to work. I just want to stay here in this place. So that's not a good attitude of a believer. We know that we are not hopeless because we have God in our life. Amen. So now they were that, and then not only that, they were also distracted. They were distracted because, for sure, when the Lord Jesus Christ was teaching them, they are focused. They know what to do. They really internalized the teaching of the Lord Jesus Christ. But during this time, when the Lord Jesus Christ died and their leader was gone, they don't know what to do. They were distracted. They were confused. If we are disappointed, we will become distracted and we're going to backslide, to go back to our former life. That's what will happen if we are distracted. So the reason why we are distracted, because of the things that move our focus from the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why God is telling us that we need to look to the Lord Jesus Christ, because if we will not keep our eyes on Him, for sure we will change our path, or we will turn. That's why our theme, turning point. So, ayun po, dapat hindi po tayo ma-distract. We are distracted because of the problem. I know when we have a meeting every Saturday, Pastor is telling us that we are distracted by this problem. Sometimes we tend to forget that we need to do something. We need to focus again to our ministry. That's what we need to do. Because of this, the devil is trying to destroy the church, and we know that. The devil is trying to destroy the church. The devil sent people. I know, and I believe that really the Bible is true, that the devil is planting tares inside the church in order to destroy, in order not to fulfill the great commission of the local church. So with that, we are distracted, but thank God, God is still gracious to us. We know that we can survive, and we know that God is always in control. God is always there. He will never leave us. So, but these people, these two people here, when they were traveling, they were disappointed because they are distracted of the things that they need to do, because the Lord Jesus Christ said, you need to do this, to do that, but they didn't do that anymore because of their situation. Because the Lord Jesus Christ died, and it seems that their hopes were gone. Nawala yung kanilang pag-asa, di ba? It's hindi ko naman sinasabing lahat ng pag-asa nila nung yung pag-asa kasi natin minsan inilalagay natin sa isang tao. Kapag ang tao na yon ay nawala, di ba, ma? Sisira na. Kaya the Bible is really clear that we don't need to trust men. We need to trust God. Ito nga, sila nga, ang Panginoong Hesus na ang kanilang pinagkatiwalaan, talagang nagtiwala sila sa Panginoon, pero na-disappoint. Because we can see here that they forget what the Lord Jesus Christ told them. So that's why when their journey is a journey of disappointment. And then next, in verse 21, it says here, verse 20, it said, and how the chief, verse 18 pala, sa 18 tayo, and the one of them whose name was Cleopas, answering, said unto him, art thou only a stranger in Jerusalem, and hast not known the things which are come to pass there in these days? Because it was famous, this event was, the crucifixion of the Lord Jesus Christ was famous because the Lord Jesus Christ, many people follow him, and then the Pharisee and the Roman government or the soldier crucified him. And he said unto them, what things? And they said unto him concerning Jesus of Nazareth, which was a prophet, mighty indeed, and word before God and all the people, and how the chief priests and our rulers delivered him to be condemned to death and have crucified him. But we trusted that it had been he which should have redeemed Israel. And beside all this today, this is the third day since these things were done. So the journey of disbelief. Their trust was gone, because before Jesus Christ is telling them that he is the Messiah, but their mindset, they think that it's still a political Messiah, that it was mentioned here that they said that Israel will redeem us to the Roman government. That's why they were disappointed. Oh, nawalan sila ng paniniwala. They doubted in verse 21. They doubted Jesus that he is their Messiah. They think it's about a political leader. Many times we doubt about God. It seems that he cannot do anything for us. The reason why God doesn't work, because of our selfish motive. So many times in our life, sometimes we have doubt. You know, even a great Bible character here, they have doubt. Remember John the Baptist? John the Baptist was in-introduced ng Panginoon kung sino si John the Baptist, that he is this man. But it's still he doubted the Lord Jesus Christ. So it is because we are still in the flesh. That's why we can experience this doubt. But God is always faithful. He will never change. That's why he says here that in verse 21, they said, but we trusted that it had been he which should have redeemed Israel. And beside all this, today is the third day since these things were gone. Sabi nila, i-deliver kami, alam namin, siya yung Messiah, pero ngayon, tatlong araw na, wala naman nangyayari. Parang ganun. Talagang lalong silang nag-doubt sa kanilang paniniwala sa Panginoon. And then in verse 24, they were defocused. In verse 24, and certain of them which were with us went to the sepulchre and found it even as the women had said, but him they say not. So nawala yung kanilang focus. They forget what Jesus taught them about what will happen to him. And we know the Lord Jesus Christ keep on telling his disciples that I will be crucified, I will die, and after 3 days I will rise again. But they forget that. They cannot recognize God anymore. And we must be always conscious about his presence in our life. You know, because sometimes when we are defocused and when we are not concentrating on God, we cannot recognize God, his presence in our life. Sometimes we forget to look at the big picture about the plan of God, remove our eyes on our Savior, Jesus Christ. That's the reason why we experience these things that it seems that really a big problem for us. But God is testing us if we can really trust him. But sometimes we become the focus in our life, like this two traveler. Not only that, after that, in verse 27, now in verse 25 until 27 says here, then he said unto them, O fools, it was a rebuke to them, and slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken. The Lord Jesus Christ started to tell them, ought not Christ to have suffered these things and to enter into his glory? And beginning at Moses and all the prophets, he expounded unto them in all the scripture the things concerning himself. Let us see here, they were discussed. Talk about in detail. The Lord Jesus Christ, God clarifies his will through the scripture, through the Bible. You know, when we are depressed, when we are defocused, only the word of God can bring us back again to to focus on Him. I don't know if you experience when you forget to read the Bible, when you don't study anymore, it seems that parang hindi mo alam kung ano gagawin mo, ba't kaya nang gagalito, parang ang laging parang iba pakiramdam mo kapag wala tayong guidance ng Panginoon. And then that's the time we need to go back to the Word of God. Because the Word of God is our light. David said, it's a light unto my feet and a lamp unto my path. So, we need to go back. That's why the Lord Jesus Christ go back to the Scripture and tell them. That's what Jesus did here. He began to unpack the Bible of the time, what we call the Old Testament, and He showed this to how the prophets through the ages had predicted not only a triumphant Messiah, but also one who would suffer and die and rise again. We don't know what verse the Jesus mentioned to them. Maybe he started in Genesis, the promise of God that he will destroy the devil and he will die and he will bruise his head. No, malamang hindi natin alam kung anong o maaring mga sa Isaiah, yung mga prophecy about the Lord Jesus Christ, because they forgot. Now, the Lord Jesus Christ, you know how gracious God to us in our life, even though we are defocused, we have doubt in our life, but God is always gracious. His word is always there to guide us, to go back again, that to remind us. That's why we are here. We always listen to the Word of God, because if we will not doubt anymore, we will not defocus, we don't need the Word of God anymore. Because we just consider, but we know that we can do that. We are, Preacher Alex said, we are not perfect. We're still in the flesh. We need the Word of God, because this is our food for our spiritual food. So God, the Lord Jesus Christ, reminded them and He rebuked them. He said, "Oh fools, mga mangmang kayo, na ba't ganyan kayo, nambilis nyong makalimot, hindi na kayo naniniwala." Di ba? Ganyan minsan nangyayari sa atin, tayo minsan nagiging mangmang pagdating sa pagtitiwala sa Panginoon. Sometimes like what we are experiencing today, we know that we really need money. But that's not the only thing that will make us continue to serve the Lord. It's not about the money. Sabi nga naka, money. It's not about that. It's all about God. You know, talagang when we heard that news na nandito lang kami dahil sa pera, parang masakit. Pero in-evaluate ko yung sarili ko. Sa'yo. Hindi naman ganun ang aking motibo. Ba't ako we came here because we want to help. We want to serve God. We want to do the ministry here, and then there's a blessing that you will have a job. Ang main purpose namin talaga pumunta rito, kami mag-asawa, first time we came here, 2009, September yun. Hindi talaga dahil sa trabaho, talagang gusto, sabi ko sa kanya, gusto ko talaga maging missionary, yung makilala sa buong mundo. hindi po. Sabi ko, I want to be, kasi, doon ako sa, nag-aral ako sa Bethany, laging may world mission, na-expose kami sa mission, talagang sabi ko, I want to become a missionary, pero ayaw naman ako isa ng church namin na mag-mission sa ano, kasi baka mabali ang church pag sinenda ko. Hindi, pero nakabuti lang na si Brother Wilson ay tumawag sa akin, sabi niya. Naalala ko, Brad, sabi niya, Brad, gusto mo bang magtrabaho rito? Ay, sige, sabi niya. Engineer ka, di ba? Maraming ma-applyan dito. Engineer. Pambira, ilang buwan na wala naman kayo ma-applyan. Sa inyo, mag-teacher ka na lang muna kasi matitrain ka naman. So, salamat sa Panginoon. But when I remember that those times, na kung talaga bang pera ang pinunta namin dito? Hindi naman pa pera, kasi kung pera lang, maraming opportunity sa ibang bansa, di ba? Pwede akong maging artista, pero hindi ko pinili yun. So, we are really masakit na Tanggapin, pero God knows our heart. And God sees what we are doing. That's why there are people who are keep on telling that it's all about the money. It's not about the money. We need money, but that's not the main purpose why we are here. And nag-uusap nga kami ng asawa ko, sabi niya, sige, pag pinagpala itong business na, kaya pag-pray niyo po yung online business namin, na sabi ko, sige, para hindi na tayo hihingi ng suporta kung kani-kanino. Kasi para bang dahil sa na-experience natin, parang mabigat na may mga taong gano'n na hindi naman natin naisip na gano'n pala ang gagawin nila, pero dahil sa mga nangyari, lumabas yung kanilang mga ugali, pero we need to, I know God is using that in order for us to be careful next time, and we need to be extra na yung maging maingat sa mga sa paglilingkod sa Panginoon. Pero salamat sa Panginoon dahil pinaranas niya tayo ng ganito, and with that we know what to do. That's why we need to always go back to the Word of God. That's what the Lord Jesus Christ told them. Nag-doubt kayo, nawala yung focus nyo kasi nawala, hindi nyo na naalala ang salita ng Panginoon. Kaya mismo ang Panginoong Jesus pinaalala sa kanila ang salita ng Diyos, ang Biblia. Kaya sila'y naliwanagan. Now after their journey of disappointment and the journey of disbelief, now the third time they go back. That's why the journey of delight. In verse 32 to 35 it says here, "And they said one to another, did our heart burn within us while he talked with us by the way, and while he opened to us the scripture?" Because they didn't recognize that it was the Lord Jesus Christ. Maybe God allowed them not to open their eyes, but God opened their eyes here at the latter part. "And they rose up the same hour and returned to Jerusalem and found the 11 gathered together, and them that were with them, saying, 'The Lord is risen indeed.'" Sabi nila, totoo na ang Panginoon talaga ay nagano. Totoo'y sinasabi ng mga babae na nabuhay ang Panginoon, kasi yung una, ayaw nilang maniwala. Sabi nila dito sa unang verses dito, sabi nila, may mga nagsabi nga babae na nabuhay, pero hindi naman namin nakita. Nawala sila. Pero nung naliwanagan na sila, na bumalik sila sa Panginoon, nakita nila, pinakinggan nila ang salita ng Diyos, it was the time they said, "The Lord is risen indeed, and hath appeared to Simon." And they told what things were done in the way, and how he was known of them in breaking of bread. And then, as they thus spake, Jesus himself stood in the midst of them and said unto them, "Peace be unto you." So their journey going back to Jerusalem, it was a journey of delight. This time they were determined, having made a firm decision and being resolved not to change it, because all their doubts were gone. It was clear to them. They fully understand the true Messiah. It's not about politics. It's not about their liberty. It's about sharing the gospel, freeing people from their sin, sharing the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. All doubts were cast aside. They said, "Jesus is alive." And because of that, everything was different. You know, in Revelation 21:5, Jesus makes all things new. They were enlightened and understand the plan of God in their life. When we go back to the Word of God, that's the time we will go back and we will be focused again, and our doubt will be gone. And not only that, they were driven or motivated. They know what to do. They know what to say. They know that God is in control. Because of that incident, because of the Lord Jesus Christ expounded to them, tell them, reminded them about the Word of God, about what will happen to him, they were motivated to share the gospel. And I know for sure they are willing to die for the Lord Jesus Christ. Compared to the time when Jesus Christ was crucified, they scattered, they ran away. Natakot sila. Mismo nga si Pedro, di ba? Si Peter, one of the closest disciple to the Lord Jesus Christ, he said, he denied God. He denied the Lord Jesus Christ. But the Lord, the Lord Jesus Christ, had mercy on him, and he was restored. And when he was restored, you know, he's willing to die for the Lord. And we know that Peter died for the Lord Jesus Christ. And also, for sure, these disciples, when they realized, when they saw that it is really true what our Master is saying is true, because it happened, they were motivated. Not only that, they declared, in verse 35, they declared the Word of God. They share the Word of God. That's why when the Lord Jesus Christ go back to heaven, they said, go ye into all the world. Ayun ina niya, mga disciples niya, di ba? Yung church nung panahon ng Panginoong Jesus. Now, when the money runs out, or problems hits hard, or sickness start up, or a person rubs us wrong, maybe we could pause before we react. Maybe we could search for Jesus on the journey. Sometimes, because our life, our Christian life is a journey, sometimes we forget that we are traveling along with God. We think that we are traveling by ourselves. That's why we are distracted. We doubt. We have disbelief because of these circumstances that happen in our life. When we catch ourselves growing discouraged, maybe we could purposefully set ourselves on a collision course with the Lord. When God speaks through His Word, everything changes. That's why we need the Word of God. Our perspective is one of the first things God usually works on. As we submit to the Lord, to the Lord's will, instead of our own, we will proclaim, "Thy will be done." And we find a new sense of joy and purpose as we discover God's will in our life. You know, this is the secret in serving God. We need to be in the will of God. We need to always align in God's will in our life. And we can find that in His Word. That's why even the Lord Jesus Christ used the Word of God in order for these people to realize that what they are doing is not good. It's not, they said, Jesus Christ said, "You're a fool because you forget, you don't believe." Now, because of that, they go back and they were really determined, motivated to serve God again. Now, in our life, because we are experiencing all these things, problem, different difficulties in life, sometimes we almost give up. Sometimes we want to stop. Sometimes we said, I think I need to go back to the Philippines to start a new life, start again. We forget that God bring us here because God has a purpose. It's not an accident that we are here. God brought us here to do something and to serve Him to according to His will. I hope this will be a reminder or an encouragement to us. Even though we know we are traveling, we need to remember that we travel along with God. God is with us, and God will never leave us. Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, Lord, thank you once again for this time. Thank you for reminding.